for CityLine to be a place that you come to for advice, inspiration, and information. We like to push the envelope and keep our viewers informed and aware. So a few weeks ago, I came out here and I stripped down in front of our national audience to show you the reality and trickery of what is often behind the images that we see on social media. Boy, oh boy, that show got a lot of attention from our viewers and I loved it. Here are a few of the responses we got because my social media was completely overrun. One woman said, listen, even those of us in the industry who know it's all smoke, mirrors, and filters are greatly impacted by the perception of perfection on TV and social media. It's something I struggle with daily. It affects my mental health. This is beyond refreshing. We're so happy you did this. Another woman wrote, this is incredible. Beyond. I love that you did this, showing the world the truth and all your beauty. This post could not be more needed and more true. Thank you for being so real. The world needs more real. One more viewer. This is what self-acceptance is all about. Love yourselves, loving ourselves with a little illusion and love ourselves without the illusion. This was so impactful. You gave a whole lot of people out there the power to look at themselves and not judge or hate, but to accept and embrace the real, which was the point. So we also got this great message from Anne, who wrote in about our No Filter Friday chats. And this is what we're going to dive in and talk a little bit about, T. So this is what Anne wrote. When I watched the episode from June 3rd, I was struck by the irony or hypocrisy of this episode. The episode talked about how awful and damaging filters are on social media because they're not someone's real appearance and they could lead to viewers feeling bad about themselves. Tracy was wearing a face full of makeup, me, and false eyelashes, as I am right now. Jamie Pandit appeared to have a softening filter on her video. Don't think she did, but Grace Lee was showing women how to fake their faces with concealer. Absolutely, we were. It feels like the show is playing both sides of this issue, giving a soft feminist girl power message, telling women that they are enough, while at the same time providing gobs of info on how to change how they visually present themselves to the world. I would be interested in how much airtime you give to helping women figure out how to be less focused on appearance to the point where looking at a filtered image is not an issue versus how many minutes of your show are dedicated to changing a person's appearance with makeup, hairstyle, and clothing. So we read that and we're like, oh, this is such a great conversation for us to have here because I totally understand what Anne is saying. One day you will watch the show when we are talking about accepting who you are, and the other day you will watch the show when we might be talking about a non-intrusive cosmetic surgery procedure that you can do. And the reason why we talk about all these things on CityLine is because we are here for all of our viewers. And the point of the show is to meet women where they are at. Mm-hmm. Some people are struggling with how to be themselves and feel like themselves and feel worthy. You're going to find information here that's going to help you. Some people want to know how to contour and have a wicked, like, fake eyelash. Mm-hmm. Like, they want the whole nine. Mm-hmm. You will find that info here. But I did like that she brought it up because what I find is happening in society right now is that people are being forced to pick sides. We all contain multitudes. We're not just about two things and having this bifurcated adversarial take on subjects. We are about showing the spectrum of perspectives that exist and the spectrum of ways that you might feel about yourself or want to embrace your journey. You will find that all here. And, you know, I also add this because I'm a public figure on social media. Not only am I speaking about the things and the struggles that I go through, but I am also a product of the environment that has created all these systems that we live within. So we need to have grace, we need to understand growth, we need to understand evolution, and we need to understand that people might need different things at different stages, different minutes of the day in their life. What is your take on Anne's message?
Well, you just took all the words out of my
mouth. Oh, shoot. I know you're going to find a better way to say it.
No, it's basically what I want to say. I don't think we have to be one way or the other. So you're not a feminist if you get surgery. You're not a feminist if you want to know how to contour.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Being a feminist means you have choice.
Yes.
So I understand where she was going with her point.
Yeah.
But at the end of the day, it's almost like, to me, it sounds like, well, we have to talk more about, like, she's like, less about talking about your appearance mm-hmm. and more about this. That means being a feminist. No, mm. all of it. To me, all of it. Mm-hmm. There's room for all of it. And when we were talking about it in that episode, because I was also in that episode
you
with
were.
False lashes and a full face.
Yes.
Too.
Yeah.
When we were talking about images and looking on social media for people who look like you, that was also for people who are struggling with
right.
that. Right? So if you are struggling with that, then that's what you should be doing to help build your self-esteem. If you're not struggling with it, then have at it. Fill your
yeah.
boots. Do what you want. Put on that red lipstick and do your lashes, and you can still be a feminist. You still have validity.
Yes.
You know what I mean? It's almost like people think, well, she's not valid. I'm not going to listen to anything.
The whole journey is valid.
The whole thing is valid.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
The whole journey is valid.
Yes.
So I just find that, what's interesting about that whole conversation as well is that it doesn't seem to be room these days for folks to sit in the middle and sort of be able to accept and experience all the things that come along. It's like if you are a body positivity person, you have to be that all the time.
Mm-hmm.
On Tuesday,
or you can't lose weight if you're a body positivity person.
You can't
person.
Lose weight
can't
now.
Lose weight.
You can't because you said you liked your body,
exactly.
so you need to keep it the same way. And I feel like that is so stymieing for so many of us. I feel that I'm going through this span of time right now where I feel so comfortable with my body, I'm almost like too far in the other extreme. I'm like, no, I look good no matter what. Like, I just feel okay about it. Like, these roles are mine and I own them. Ask me in a month if I feel that way.
Right. It goes up
I
and down.
I might not feel that way. I might feel
right.
like I need to eat, like, spinach salads and, like, get some more, like...
That's why
that's
we need to be talking about the whole spectrum, Tracy.
Yes.
That's why we need to be talking about all of it.
It's not always about pretending that you've got all the answers either. And
yeah.
I don't think that City Line necessarily does that. I think what we say is, where are you at? And what's the information we can give you today to make you feel like your best self?
Yes.
Is that going to be a full face of makeup?
Yes, for me,
is it going to be fake hair?
Mm-hmm.
Are we going to show you how to cover up your alopecia with a wig today?
Mm-hmm.
Tomorrow, are we going to show you how to claim the fact that you have a plus size body and you want to find some jean shorts that look good and that look good on you?
Yes.
What is there? To me, there's nothing wrong with that.
There's
and I'm
nothing
so
wrong
proud
with it.
Of what the show does daily to meet women where they're at and to let you know that regardless of where you are on your journey, the spectrum of feelings and perspectives, I hope we're going to have a nugget or a tidbit for you so that your day is going to be a little bit better than it was the day before. Take what you need from the show, guys.
Yes.
And Anne, thank you so much for chiming in. Keep that coming. Thanks to our viewers for sharing feedback with us always. And thank you, T, for always being here to have these discussions, because these discussions start in the makeup room and they continue on to the show.